How about the latest on Alvin Kamara? Look, he deserves new money. Unequivocally, he deserves a new contract, but he doesn't deserve Christian McCaffrey money. Let's be clear here. I would never trade Alvin Kamara. I don't think the Saints should or would trade Alvin Kamara. Look, I say that knowing they once traded Brandon Cooks, they once traded Jimmy Graham, and they were successful last year when Kamara was hurt and Latavius Murray ran the football. Listen, Christian McCaffrey's best running back in the NFL. He is special. Alvin Kamara is not better than Saquon Barkley. He's not better at the end of the day than Ezekiel Elliott. I don't think he's better than Derrick Henry. I think he deserves to get $12 to $13 million a year. That's the money. That's what he should get. Now, I think if you're New Orleans, you're going to have to, you know, basically make sure you take care of him, just like Joe Mixon got taken care of. 4 for $48 million when you look at it from the Cincinnati Bengals. I think Kamara is a straw that stirs the drink. And that kind of contract, to me, he's worthy. Remember, they also have to pay Ramczyk, the offensive tackle. They got to pay Lattimore, the cornerback. And they just paid Taysom Hill. And, you know, that's certainly something that is a bit funky when you look at the AAV in terms of the salary for this upcoming season. You know, Taysom Hill getting $10 million and Alvin Kamara getting $2 million in the final year of his rookie contract. And, oh, by the way, he passed for almost as many yards as Taysom Hill last season, which makes me chuckle that we threw that on the board. Yeah, Alvin Kamara deserves to get a new contract, and he's not easily replaceable. I don't want to hear that, well, he was nicked and knacked last year, and, you know, he was better when Mark Ingram was there. Alvin Kamara is a superstar. He's just not as good as Christian McCaffrey and shouldn't be paid more than Ezekiel Elliott. He's in that Derrick Henry, and he is in that Joe Mixon kind of range. I don't blame Donovan Mitchell for falling to the ground because I thought that was in. Big Honey, Nikola Jokic, and the Denver Nuggets on that go-ahead bucket. Jokic carries and powers the Denver Nuggets to a series victory. This was absolutely positively wild. And honestly, that ending last night, that's why you love sports. A couple of things. Number one, I thought that was incredible defense by Gary Harris, who is really an integral player for the Denver Nuggets, and you saw that in terms of his defensive presence in Game 6 and Game 7. I don't blame Donovan Mitchell at all. I thought that was just great defense. Jamal Murray pushing it up the court, not dribbling out so he could get fouled at the end of that game. That was crazy. Then, of course, you see the missed layup. I mean, you make that in CYO basketball. Come on, Greg, you got to hit that. And then Rudy Gobert gets the rebound, the outlet to Conley. I don't want to hear he should have passed it to Donovan Mitchell, who was open. That's a split-second decision. Listen, at the end of the day, that was basically in. That would have won this series for Utah. I don't think that was a bad shot. It just rimmed out. I feel terrible for Donovan Mitchell. Oh, just awful. And listen, this was a 3-1 series lead at one point for the Utah Jazz. And they had a 15-point lead in game number 5, and they blew it. And then Jamal Murray went off in game 6. And listen, I thought Mitchell was excellent last night in the second half after a lackluster first half. Rudy Gobert was awesome in the second half. I thought this was going to be a major come-from-behind victory for Donovan Mitchell. Listen, we'll always remember what happened with Murray and Mitchell in this series. It was absolutely positively historic. It was absolutely positively breathtaking. Donovan Mitchell deserved better. I like what he said after the game. Look, he blamed himself for what transpired in game number 1 with the 8-second violation and a game where he scored 50 points. You know, he blamed himself for what transpired last night with the turnovers. You know, I honestly thought Utah was dead and buried in the first half. And, you know, I picked Utah to win the game when the series, when they were down 50-36 at the half. I just thought there was no chance they were going to come back. That was an NCAA tournament-esque finish. That was wildly entertaining. Utah will never get over it. Denver, they survive. I think they're going to lose in the next round to the Clippers in six games. But that finish last night, wow, you got to love sports.